Hi guys, welcome to another video. Today's video is going to be on my Alexander Wang Rocco bag. If you have seen my prior videos, you know that I got it pre-loved from Poshmark and I got a great deal on it. And I also did a video on how I cleaned it and conditioned it. So I've been using it now for over, I want to say almost 2 months now. And I still really, really love it. I'm actually considering in maybe getting the Rocky one, which is a smaller one, but maybe, but due time. However, I will tell you the measurements of the bag, how much it weighs, and how much it can fit in here. Right now it's very heavy because I have a lot of stuff in here, like a lot of stuff, and it still has room for a lot more. It's a very deceiving bag. It looks like it wouldn't hold that much, but it really holds a lot. So let's start with the strap. The strap will come like this. This strap here, piece of the strap, you're able to move up or down. I have been using it on my shoulder and it seems very comfortable. However, I know that some people may not like that, so you're able to just push it all the way to the bottom. That would slide in your way. One of the sides of the strap has this clip that will clip to your D-ring right here. And it, authentic ones will say Alexander Wang in all caps. Also, the opposite side of the strap, take it out, will be like this. So you're gonna have three holes to adjust it how you like. I've been wearing it on the last one because I am shorter, I'm only 5'2". It kind of works a crossbody, but it's not like an actual crossbody for me. But at times I do wear it as a crossbody when I'm shopping or just to get out of my way. But you're able to adjust it through different sizes, 2, 3. And then once you pick your size, just push this up. Just put it right there. Now, how long is the strap? I have this little measuring tape here. So I'm gonna just take it from the ring to the bottom of how I wear it. So up to the, actually, let's do the whole thing. Trying to measure the whole strap. So the strap is approximately 36 inches. That's without me folding it over. Fold it back. I'm gonna leave the strap off for now. But another thing that you want to make sure on your bag is, well, one thing that I learned is that with time, the pebbling on the bag will not be as, I guess it won't show as much, but you can still feel it and see it around the entire bag. You can see it. I can totally feel it though, but you'll see it more in some areas than others. There was like 3 videos and an online review that I saw that with time, the pebbling can, it will kind of lose a little bit of texture. So your handles are very comfortable. Well, for me, they're very comfortable and they're very sturdy. I've been wearing it on my forearm just like this. It works great. It can get carried pretty heavy because the bag alone is pretty heavy. And that is because of these lovely studs that make up the entire bag. Now, I know they come in different colors. They have, this is the silver. They have like a black, a nice colorful one, rose gold and gold. Now depending on when the bag was done, the studs may be a little different. We open, the zipper runs smoothly. Let me show what's in my bag quickly. This is my makeup bag, just not too smart or large. My little journal note-taking book here. I have my work phone, my wallet, car keys and house key. And I have my iPad mini that I carry with me. Okay, let's empty down. Inside, you will have the Alexander Wang patch here. Again, it's all caps. And you have one pocket inside like this with the zipper. I don't know if it's just me or what, but I barely ever use any side pockets on any of my bags. I just feel like, I don't know, I never put anything in there. And the few times that I do use it, it's like a lipstick or a chapstick, and then when I go back, it's not there or I lost it. But anyways, the interior of this bag is black. I've been Googling what you call the color of my handbag. It's like to me it's like a forest green or like a really deep olive green, but I have yet to find the actual name of the color of the bag. Now on the sides of the bag, you're gonna find that it has, well, looks like this, but it has secret compartments. On one side, you have one zipper, and it's a little pocket. And on the other side, you have another zipper, which is another little pocket. This is not the same pocket. They're two different pockets. So if you put something here, and you try to open the other side, you're not gonna be able to get it out. So I haven't used these for anything. I think it'd be good to use, like, if you want to have easy access to a chapstick or your keys, maybe. I don't know, my work phone. Nope. This is a Galaxy 10 and it does not fit here. So it's just little hidden side pockets. I just really like this. Like, I feel like this just makes the entire bag, and this is the reason why I got the bag. Because if you put it on the floor, I really, really try not to put my bags on the floor, but if you do, then you have these studs here that are able to keep it from getting damaged. So that's what I really like about it. Besides that, if you saw my video, it's very easy to clean and maintain. Ever since I bought it, I've been getting a lot of compliments on it, and I really like how it looks for either very casual look or if I want kind of a dressy look. I took off the strap and I just use it with the handles. But overall, I'm really pleased with it. Also, one thing is when I store it, I stuff it with either towels or tissue. Just because I don't like how slouchy it looks when I put it on my shelf, and it's just, this is fine, but usually when I put it on my shelf, it's like bent in or something, and I just don't like that. I want it to maintain its shape and keep it up. One thing I am a little concerned about is, let's see, one of these sides. I can't find it now, but it looks like a little bit of piping is running slightly thin. So I'm gonna try to condition that and keep an eye on it, make sure I don't rub it because I don't wanna rip it or tear it. But this bag has, it's just a big, large hole inside where you can fit so much. I feel like it's kind of like a Speedy 30. Maybe I should do a video on a comparison of what fits in the Alexander Wang Rocco bag versus what fits in the Speedy 30. So keep an eye out for that video. Now I'm gonna go ahead and put it on a scale to see how much it weighs. It's completely empty, so we'll put it on the scale. So according to my little scale that I have here, it's 2 pounds and 10.8 ounces. I will take a picture. These are just approximate estimated of what the bag may weigh. So this is not exactly what it may or may not weigh. I'm just doing this for a review so that you have an idea of what you're getting. Because I have heard that some of the fake Alexander Wang bags, they may look to the eye great, but they're not even heavy at all, or this may be plastic. What else have I heard? Yeah, that the pebbling, it looks pebble, but when you touch it, it's just very flat. So I haven't bought a fake one to compare it with, but that's just what I've heard. And how big is this bag? Or how long? On one side, it's really hard to hold this up and make the bag flat and try to measure it. So it's about, and we can tell here, but it's about 12 inches long, 12 and a half ish, almost 13 inches long. And this will be on the side, which is about 8 inches. So this here, it's about 10 and a half or 11 inches on the height. So the strap drop is about 6 inches. So I only really wanted to do a video to give you a review on what the Alexander Wang Rocco bag actually measures, because when I was looking to buy it, it said medium, and I'm thinking, no, I want the larger bag, but this is the medium bag. There is the Rocky, which is smaller than this one, and they look a lot alike. The other one has a zipper. Instead of going straight across, it kind of like curves a little bit. Which is really cute. If you like this bag and you think it's too big or too heavy, you can go for the Rocky. So sometimes the sellers, they don't know that there's a Rocky or a Rocco. They might just assess Alexander Wang bag. And if you don't know the measurements, or they don't give you the measurements, then you don't know if you're buying the Rocky or the Rocco, especially if you don't know what the Rocky and the Rocco look like. So this is just things that I wanted to share with you so that I can help you with your purchase, especially if you're buying a pre-love, because even today I googled Alexander Wang Rocco bag, and Nordstrom's didn't have any, Saks didn't have any, their website didn't have any, so it seems to always be sold out. It seems to be a popular bag. I did find a few Rockies, but not the Roccos. And again, this bag retails, I think, for close to $1,000 as of now. But I got a great deal on Poshmark, thanks to a lovely seller and her kindness. So I love that it's a beautiful bag. I love that it's functional. I love that I got a great deal on it. And I hope you find an awesome deal too if you're looking to find a pre-loved one. Once again, guys, thank you for watching my channel. I appreciate you. And if you like my videos, please go ahead and give me a thumbs up. If you have any comments or questions or any of your own experiences with your Alexander Rain Morocco bag, please go ahead and share that with me. I love to get your feedback. I love to hear from you guys. I love to stay in touch with you guys. And if you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and do so. And I will see you next time. Thanks.